Today I'm making a video about uBlock Origin, which is another ad blocker or an option to AdBlock Plus. Some people don't like AdBlock Plus just because they allow non-intrusive ads. I don't really have a problem with non-intrusive ads, so I can't really say anything bad about AdBlock Plus. There are claims and proof of that AdBlock Plus uses more memory, but I've been using it for a long time. But it was suggested that I try uBlock Origin by a commenter, and so I'm trying it and I really like it. It basically does the same thing as AdBlock Plus with the less use of CPU and memory. Some of the settings are different, some of them are the same. And here is the link or the page where you can get it from Firefox add-ons. It also works in Chrome. And I will put the link in the video description for you to take a look at later and read the information. It's pretty easy to understand. And now we will go on to uBlock Origin's dashboard. And as you can see, just by clicking the icon up here in the right-hand corner, there's a lot of information for you here, and you can choose to allow or block things over here where my mouse is if it's not already blocked. And this is the element zapper, like if there's some sort of element like a recommended video on YouTube you don't want to see, or an ad, or just something that you don't want to see on the page. And this is the element picker mode, and I guess that allows you to pick certain elements rather than all of the elements. And then there's a logger, and here is the dashboard where all the settings are. We won't go there quite yet. And here's a button to block all pop-ups from a site. Now this is what I like about uBlock Origin. I go to some questionable movie and TV show viewing websites, and they have sometimes malicious pop-ups, and so far uBlock has blocked them all. I haven't seen any. And if you're familiar with those sites, you know even right-clicking a page can cause a pop-up. And then click to block large media elements on this site. I'm not really familiar. I've just started using this and I haven't had a chance to use that. And the next thing is disable cosmetic filtering on this site. And that would allow like everything to appear, which may use more memory again in CPU. And block remote fonts on this website. So I'm guessing that means if the font is stored on a server somewhere to be displayed on a website, then it will block that. And then, of course, disable JavaScript, which is also helpful sometimes if you're having a problem with the JavaScript on a web page. Now I will go into the dashboard or the settings. And out of the box, most of the default settings are perfect for like anybody, whether you're a novice or advanced user of like an ad blocker. But all of these settings are pretty much the way I left them default. The only one on this page under settings, I unchecked show number of blocked requests on the icon because I don't really need to know that. And I put a check mark in I'm an advanced user. And everything under privacy I left default, and the default behavior I left all of these unchecked because that's what they were by default. Now filter lists, these were all selected for me ahead of time. I just had to update them, and it automatically updates. As you can see, that's the first option. And so this badware risks and malware domain list and malware domains helps block some of those pop-ups that you get from those questionable websites. And you still can use EasyList. If you came from AdBlock Plus, you're probably familiar with EasyList and EasyList privacy. And then under my filters, I have nothing there yet. And also under my rules, I have nothing there yet. that isn't default. And then for the whitelist, which was a point of contention with the commenter who suggested this add-on, I did have to whitelist google.com/AdSense so I could check my AdSense. So that's not a big deal. It was really simple. And I didn't have to whitelist the entire google.com, although uBlock wanted to whitelist the entire google.com. And so I just manually typed it in and added an asterisk. So the URL starts with google.com/AdSense. It is whitelisted. Now for shortcuts, I didn't do anything there. And again, this is just the About tab, and it tells you that it's made by Raymond Hill. And it gives you the change log, support link, and other information about this add-on. But so far, it works really well. I have had no problems with it. Even on YouTube, it does block the ads. I will quickly try to find one of my own videos to prove that it does block ads. I won't go to any other website because then there could be a copyright problem. So here I am on my most recent video. And as you can see, there's absolutely no ads on the video, even though monetization is enabled. Even down here with the progress bar of the video player, you can see that there is no yellow marks where they would place ads, and there's no ad up here on the right hand side. So it does work, it does block ads, and it also blocks some malicious pop-ups that are the biggest problem for me right now. So if you do give it a try, leave a comment below, and if you have any questions, leave a comment and I'll try to help you. Subscribe or visit my YouTube channel.